Good morning. If we slowly raise this end of the board, we can solve for the coefficient of static friction between the book and the incline.
Flippin' physics.
Bobby, what are our known values?
Well, it looks like the book starts to slide when the incline angle is 15 degrees. I think that's it.
And what exactly are we solving for?
The coefficient of static friction equals question mark.
The moment we are interested in this demonstration is the moment right before the book starts to slide, and the angle of the incline at that moment is 15 degrees. Billy, please give us a free body diagram of all the forces acting on the book right before the book starts to slide.
The force of gravity is down, the board pushes up on the book, which is the force normal, which is perpendicular to the incline and up. The force of static friction is parallel to the incline and opposes the motion of the book. Without friction, the book would slide down the incline, so the force of static friction is up and parallel to the incline.
And now, could you please break the force of gravity into its components?
Okay. Instead of the force of gravity, we can now substitute in its components. The force of gravity parallel, which is parallel to and down the incline, and the force of gravity perpendicular, which is perpendicular to the incline and down.
Bo, could you please do the next step?
Next, we need to sum the forces. Let's do the parallel direction. The net force in the parallel direction equals force of gravity parallel, which is positive because it is to the right, and force of static friction, which is negative because it's to the left. And this also equals mass times acceleration in the parallel direction. But I don't know what to do now.
Bo, that's fine. Class, what is the acceleration of the book in the parallel direction before the book starts to move?
Zero.
Therefore, before the book starts to move, the force of gravity parallel and the force of static friction are equal in magnitude. So notice as the incline angle increases, the force of gravity down the incline, what we call the force of gravity parallel, increases. Therefore, the force of static friction, which adjusts in magnitude to keep the book from sliding relative to the incline, also increases. The force of static friction continues to increase until the magnitude of the force of gravity parallel is just barely above the magnitude of the maximum force of static friction, at which point the friction switches from static to kinetic, decreases in value, and the book begins to accelerate down the incline. Therefore, we use the maximum force of static friction in our equation because the force of static friction is at its maximum value when the incline is at 15 degrees. And because it is static friction, we know the book isn't moving yet, which means the acceleration in the parallel direction is equal to zero. Bobby, why don't you substitute in some equations, please?
Force of gravity parallel is mass times gravity
acceleration due to gravity.
Mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta, which equals force of static friction maximum, which is the coefficient of static friction times force normal. We need force normal.
Force normal equals force of gravity.
No, it doesn't.
No.
Yes, it does. Force normal equals mass times acceleration due to gravity. Got it in my notes. Somewhere.
Force normal does not equal the force of gravity. Many students think it does, however, it does not. Now, I will admit that often it does. However, you have to, every time, draw a free body diagram and sum the forces in order to solve for the force normal. Bo, please solve for the force normal.
The net force in the perpendicular direction equals force normal minus force of gravity perpendicular, which equals mass times acceleration perpendicular. Acceleration in all directions is zero, so force normal equals force of gravity perpendicular, which equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta. Pretty much equals force of gravity. It's just force of gravity perpendicular instead. Doesn't really matter.
Billy, please continue.
We can substitute for force normal, mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta, into the equation we had from the net force in the parallel direction. We now have mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta equals the coefficient of static friction times mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta. Everybody brought mass to the party.
Actually, everybody brought the force of gravity to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
And we can divide both sides by the cosine of the incline angle, and the sine of theta over cosine theta equals tangent theta. Therefore, the coefficient of static friction between the book and the incline is equal to the tangent of the incline angle right before the book starts to slide. Pretty cool, eh?
That is pretty cool.
I guess.
We could plug in 15 degrees for our incline angle, and we get that the coefficient of static friction between the book and the incline is 0.267949, or 0.27 with two significant digits. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.